Present you a clinical case. So this is a child, 5 years. He has a fever and dyspnea. So we do a chest pin, and you can see this. So there is an opacity of the mediastinum and of the left lung. You can see a deflection of the mediastinum. And auto tracker. Yeah. Right. To the left. We do a lateral view. The mass is not anterior. This is this. And after we do an US. And you can see the Macy's, who is this one. And intermissions. We do a CT. And as you can see, there is a mass of the middle mediastinum with a deviation of the heart. So what the diagnosis? No surprise. We're doing a biopsy, and it was a lymphoma. So I will speak to you of the mediastinal masses in children, and only the most current diagnosis, because there is a lot of diagnosis, so I can speak of it all. We have to see the topography, so we have to distinguish anterior mediastinum, middle mediastinum, and posterior mediastinum. The anterior mediastinum is until the anterior wall of the trachea. The middle mediastinum is between the anterior mediastinum and a parallel line to the sole of the rib cage. As you can see here, and behind, this is the posterior mediastinum. What is the diagnostic strategy? First, we do a chest pin, AP and lateral views, and an ultrasound to say if the mass is liquid or solid. And after, we have to see the extension, so we can do a CT or an MRI. A CT is for the anterior or the middle mediastinum, and we can see pleural effusion calcification, the size, the density, the vascular structures, the extension of cerebral, pulmonary, abdominal, intraspinal. But to see the infraspinal extension, the MRI is better, so we do this for the posterior mediastinum. Don't forget this aspect, the cell shape. This is the normal thymus. It never deviates the trachea. So when we have a mass of the anterior mediastinum, it will be it could be a large tumor or a thymic it would be thymic hyperplasia, cyst, teratoma. So a thymic hyperplasia is before 1 year, is asymptomatic and it won't squeeze the trachea. A thymic cyst could be congenital or secondary to aplasia, post-operative, of a malignant tumor or HIV. The other thymic tumor are thymolipoma. You can see fat density on CT. Teratoma, you can see calcification and cystic lymph. Macedonia, you can see system partitions. This is an example of a teratoma. You can see calcification. The lymphoma and the leukemia are the most common masses of the chondrial mediastinum. The association with pleural pericardial effusion is frequent, is common. The masses could be tissular or cystic. Tissular are adenopathy in an infection of lymphoma. Cystic masses could be cause of calcification or oncogenesis. The adenopathy may be infectious, like in tuberculosis. This is the same for the anterior mediastinum. And this is the leading cause. It could be metastatic, rarely, neurovascular or testicular cancer. Oncogenic cyst is a mediastinal cystic tumor. This is a natural protein of the pancreatic trait during embryogenesis. On CT, it appears well the density is between 0 to 14 in suite. This is an example. You can see persistent masses. And another example. The threshold duplication is a round malformation, often associated with electric duplication. The partial duplication is most common. And this is a sharply marginated maze with homogeneous frequency, and there is no answer. And for the posterior mediastinum, the most current are neurogenic tumors, like neuroblastoma, and the other causes are hemisarcoma and spinal sclerosis. The neurogenic tumors, neuroblastoma, pompidoneuroblastoma, neuroblastoma. They are you can see calcification, bone lesion, and to see the extension, you do a fundamental. An example of calcification. In a conclusion, first we do a plain field and NUS. The CT is better for the anterior mediastinum 30, and for the posterior mediastinum, we do an MRI to see the spinal extension.